Hey Tracy, here's an idea for you on that YouTube video. The challenge with a web object is that because it's completely independent of your course, there's really no way for Storyline to know that the learner has actually watched the movie all the way through. But here's an idea that I think will come close to what you're looking for. So here's my web object that I've added to my slide. I've got this little message at the top telling the learner what they need to do. And let me just refresh this from the beginning of the timeline. So if I get to this slide and I decide I'm going to skip through and I click next, I'm going to get this message up here saying I got to watch the video before I move on. So I'll go ahead and start the movie. And this is a movie of an ice cream sandwich melting in the heat. And let's say I get bored with this, I try to click next again, and then I get the message again, and then it'll fade out in a second. Maybe I'll get bored again, I try again, I get the message again. So if that happens to me as the learner, you know, a couple of times, I'm probably going to be pretty well resolved to the fact that I got to watch the movie all the way through. And then once it ends, I can click next, and then here's my next slide. So let me show you how we set that up. It's not entirely foolproof, and I'll tell you why in a second, but I think it will probably come close to what you're looking for. So first thing I did is the movie that I embedded here is 24 seconds long. So I came down to my timeline and I just extended the duration of the timeline out to about the 24 second mark. Because what we're going to do is basically require the learner to sit on this slide for at least 24 seconds. With the idea that, you know, if they sit there that long, then they've probably watched the movie in its entirety or at least close to it, and then we'll let them move on after that. Another thing I did is I created a slide layer here that displays if the learner does happen to click next before those 24 seconds are up, okay? And the way that we control that is with a true false variable. So I'm going to click on my Manage Project Variables button, this little X down here in the lower right of the trigger panel. And here's my variable. Let me just show you how you set it up. If I click create a new variable, you can call it whatever you want. I called mine video slide complete, and this is going to be a true false variable, okay? And its initial value is going to be set to false because they haven't, you know, sat on the slide long enough to be worthy enough to move on yet, okay? So you would call this false and then click okay. So that's all I did to set up the variable. And then on the base layer of the slide, what we did is added a trigger here. This is real easy to set up. Basically, we just tell Storyline to adjust the variable that we just created called video slide complete. We want to change it to a value of true when the timeline of this slide ends. So if the learner gets to that 24 second mark, then we're going to call this variable true instead of false. And then we kind of use that as the gatekeeper that determines whether they're allowed to move on when they click that next button. And here's how we do that. You can change the default trigger on the next button. So let me just open up that. At the beginning of a course, you know, when you first open a course and start working on it,